Thanks for joining us. Valley News Live, a look at the Dakota Magic Casino. Beautiful day to swing the clubs out there once again. Summer-like, take something to stay cool. Remember the sunscreen. We're in the middle of summer, and folks, July is here, July 1. Let's take a look at your holiday planning forecast first and foremost as we head into the weekend of the 4th. First and foremost, keep in mind that each and every day will bring heat, many of us between 90 and 100 degrees. Records will be challenged for sure as we go through Saturday and on Sunday on the 4th of July. Looks dry for most of us on Saturday. There could be a sprinkle out in western parts of the Dakotas Saturday night, but for us, we'll have a couple of chances on our 4th of July. Maybe a morning sprinkle, it'll be isolated, then one or two afternoon storms forming. So most of us stay dry and quite hot. The ice cream forecast is looking mighty, drippy, if you can call it that, because it won't last long. Make sure you get the tongue ready and watch out for brain freeze because you don't want to eat it too fast. Here's a look at your current conditions right now. The ice cream melting at 89 degrees at Hector 90 at Moorheads Airport. Calm wind and very hot outside right now. As we look at the heat, we have generally all of us near that 90 degree mark. From the Red River Valley counties and Lakes Country all the way out to our western counties, and a noticeably cooler trend as we go into central Minnesota as forecast. There's a few more clouds there, and you're on the side of a cool pool of air that's retreating off to the east. Quiet radar conditions across Minnesota with a couple of clouds. That's it. We do have showers and thunderstorms rumbling through the central Rockies. Colorado, Wyoming, that extends all the way through the Ohio River Valley on a line from Oklahoma up into the upstate New York area, where we have scattered showers and locally heavy rain. For us, there's very little in the chance of rain. As we go through the 24-hour forecast, here's what you can expect. After sunset tonight, things will cool rather quickly, and we'll dip down into those 60s as we go through the overnight hours. So the nicest time of the day will be that very, very early hours of the day when we'll be rising quickly as we go from the low 60s all the way up to the 80s by your lunch hour to near 90 for some of our western counties. Tomorrow, sunny for all. It does look like the heat will spread into central Minnesota as well, so you too will warm. And the wind picks up from the south out in our western counties. We'll have some gusts 15 to 20 miles per hour. Hey, are you traveling for the holiday weekend? As you get started early on your Friday afternoon, you could see a few Black Hills area showers and thunderstorms, and also out near Medora, maybe some passing clouds and showers. Remember, it's much needed out in the western part with quiet conditions for all of Minnesota on your Friday, and it looks to stick around for most of the weekend as well. So the grilling forecast for tomorrow shows temperatures will be sizzling hot all day long with 92 for that dinner hour barbecue if you happen to be grilling outside. Your hometown forecast shows all of us near 90, really, with the best chance at some mid-90s out in the James River Valley, Aberdeen to Jamestown and points west. Gorgeous shot here. Hopefully you can get somewhere that makes you smile this holiday weekend. And this would make me smile. Beautiful Lake Lida, wonderful shot. Planning forecast Saturday and Sunday, as we started with, is going to be hot. A couple of thunderstorms on the 4th of July. And remember, the morning could have some isolated sprinkles as well. As we carry you through into next week, we get cooler on Monday after the passage of a cool front, but not necessarily cold. Spotty Tuesday showers, but the best chance of rain, Stacy, appears to me to come on a sizzling hot forecast as we go into your Thursday. Some widespread storms, one or two might be strong. We'll keep you posted. That's a long ways away. So mainly dry all the way until late next week, and that's how we start July.
We're keeping those temperatures high, aren't we? Woo!
Indeed we are.
All right, thanks, Hutch.
Yes.
From swimming to canoeing, cities are joining together to promote their local parks during the month of July. There are more than 200 parks in the metro, each offering their own amenities like basketball and tennis courts, playgrounds, and river access. Some even offer outdoor exercise equipment and places to repair your bike. Moorheads Recreation Coordinator says it's all about bringing people together while making active living a fun factor in your life.
We're all one. We're all trying to put on fun events. We're all trying to get people active. To me, that's the main goal. Let's just keep the community as active as we can be, no matter, you know, what side of the river you're living on.
And if you're looking for some new parks to explore, we have a list right on our website, valleynewslive.com. Just click on this story. Whether you're taking a car or a plane this holiday weekend, you might run into some roadblocks. We'll break down the issues at the pump and the airport right after the break.